Hello class 9th, hope you all are good. Now children, today also we will continue the same chapter, that is your water. And in this chapter I am revising only the part which is in your syllabus, right? So first we will discuss about the solvents which we use in our daily life, then about the solubility, what is solubility, and how the solubility of different substances like solids and gases are affected by the temperature and pressure, right? And what is water of crystallization, hydrated salts and hydrous substances, and efflorescent and deliquescent substance. Let's start first the solvent which we use in our daily life. There are so many solvents which we use in our daily life. For example, petrol, kerosene and ammonia solutions, they are used in laundries and dry cleaners, right, for removing grease stains. Even turpentine is used for removing paint stains, and borax solution is used for removing coffee or tea stain. Now there are some solvents which are used in the manufacturing of perfume. For example, aromatic oils, they are dissolved in alcohol. So alcohol is used in manufacturing of perfumes. Now extraction of chlorophyll in laboratory, all of you know, when you go in class 10th, you will, in bio you will learn during the starch test, this alcohol is used for removing chlorophyll. By when you boil the leaf in alcohol, then this it will turn white. Why? Because alcohol remove chlorophyll from the leaves. Next is your dressing wounds in dispensary. Iodine dissolved in alcohol is used as a tincture of iodine, which is used to heal up the wounds. Okay, now what is solubility? Solubility is actually what, how much amount of solute can be dissolved in a given solvent at a given temperature, right? Or you can say it is a maximum amount of solute in grams which can dissolve which can be saturated or which can be dissolved in 100 gram of the solvent at the given temperature is called what? Solubility. So in simple way, what is solubility? Solubility is the maximum amount of solute which can dissolve in 100 gram of solvent at given temperature, right? Now solubility is affected by temperature. If you increase the temperature, so there are some substances whose solubility increases, and there are some substances whose solubility decreases with rise in temperature. Okay, now next is your what? What is qualitative effect of temperature on solubility? Qualitative effect meaning when we increase the temperature gradually, how is the solubility is going to be affected? Means when you are increasing in the temperature, how the solubility of a particular substance is going to be affected is called what? Qualitative effect of temperature on solubility. And in your syllabus, you have to learn only these three substance solubility, that is your potassium nitrate, sodium chloride and calcium sulfate. Just look at here, when you increase the temperature, the solubility increases, of which this potassium nitrate is a substance whose solubility increases with increase in temperature. Now next is your, with increase in temperature, solubility increases slightly, that is your sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is a substance whose solubility increases slightly or little bit with increase in temperature. Now third is your solubility, solubility of calcium sulfate decreases when we increase the temperature. Means on increasing temperature, the solubility of calcium sulfate decreases. Question may ask, name the substance whose solubility decreases with increase in temperature, that is your calcium sulfate. Or name the substance whose solubility increases slightly with increase in temperature, that is your sodium chloride. And the substance whose solubility increases with increase in temperature, that is your potassium nitrate. In your syllabus, only these solubility of these three substances are you have to learn. Okay, now next is your effect of pressure on solubility of gas in water. All of you know that when you increase the pressure on the surface of water, the solubility of a gas is also increases. Means it is directly proportional. Pressure is directly proportional to the solubility of a gas in water. Means pressure increases, solubility also increases. If pressure decreases, solubility also decreases. And very good example is your the question is also there, that is soda water bottle opens with fizz sound. Why? Because all of you know soda water contain what? Carbon dioxide, which is dissolved in water under pressure. But when you open the bottle, the gas rapidly bubbles out with fizz sound, since the pressure on the surface of the soda water suddenly decreases. On decreasing pressure, the solubility of the carbon dioxide also decreases, and that's why it comes out with a fizz sound. Right, now next is your if pressure increases on the surface of water, always remember children, its boiling point increases but freezing point decreases. Right, on increasing pressure, boiling point increases and freezing point decreases. Now next is your effect of temperature on solubility of gases in water. On increasing temperature, it causes decrease in solubility of gas in water. Means they are inversely proportional to each other. What? Temperature is inversely proportional to the solubility of a gas. When you increase the temperature, solubility decreases. But when you decrease temperature, solubility increases. Right? And all of you know ki why water loses its taste on boiling, or what, boiled water tastes flat. Why? Because water contains soluble gases which contribute to the taste of water. But when you boil the water, then what's happened? The temperature of the water increases, and thereby the solubility of the dissolved gases decreases, and the dissolved gases, they are hence expelled out. So when there is no gases in the water, then it tastes flat, or the water loses its taste. Right, so learn these two points. Increase in pressure, solubility of the gas increases. Increase in temperature, the solubility of gases decreases. Understood? Okay, now next is your water of crystallization. Actually, there are some substances which contain water molecule in their loose combination. And what is water of crystallization? It is a fixed number of water molecules which enters into a loose chemical combination with the substance when the substance is crystallized from its hot saturated solution is called water of crystallization. So learn this definition. What is it? Crystallization is a fixed number of water molecules which enter into a loose chemical combination with the substance when the substance is crystallized from its hot saturated solution. Okay, now on the basis of this presence of this water of crystallization, the substances are divided into two categories. First is called hydrated substance, and second is called what? Anhydrous substance. What are hydrated substance? The substance which contain fixed number of water molecules in their loose chemical combination, then the substance is called hydrated substance. Right, and anhydrous substances are which does not contain any fixed number of molecules in loose chemical combination with the substance, then what you will say, it is called what? Anhydrous substance. Now there are some examples of hydrated substances are there, just learn these one. First is your what? Gypsum. Formula of gypsum is your calcium sulfate dot 2H2O, and it is also called dehydrated crystal. Right, next you will learn blue vitriol, that is your copper sulfate dot 5H2O, and it is a pentahydrate salt. Next is your Epsom salt, that is your magnesium sulfate dot 7H2O, and it is a heptahydrate, means it contains seven molecule of water of crystallization. Third is next is your green vitriol, that is your FeSO4 7H2O, and it is also called heptahydrate because it contains seven molecule of water of crystallization. And last is your globose salt, that is your sodium sulfate 10 HO, and it is a decahydrate, right? Because it contains 10 molecule of water of crystallization. So learn these hydrated crystals or hydrated substance, right, with their formula and common name. Now next is your anhydrous crystals. All the salts like your potassium sulfate, ammonium sulfate, potassium chloride, lead chloride, even your sodium chloride, they all are what? These are anhydrous crystals. Means the anhydrous substance, because they do not contain any fixed number of water of crystallization molecule in loose chemical combination. Okay, now one is here. Okay, suppose you have a hydrated copper sulfate. When you heat hydrated copper sulfate, it is blue in color. What is the color of this hydrated copper sulfate? It is blue in color. And on heating, what's happened? It loses this water of crystallization and change into copper sulfate and 5 HO. And this copper sulfate is called anhydrous copper sulfate. What this copper sulfate is called? Anhydrous copper sulfate. And it turn into what? White. It means this water of crystallization gives what? Color to the substance as well as crystal form also. Right, so question may ask, what do you observe on when copper sulfate, hydrated copper sulfate is heated? So what you will say, it change from blue to white because it loses water of crystallization, right? And now turn into anhydrous, meaning amorphous in nature. Amorphous means it change into powder form. While your copper sulfate 5H2, that is your hydrated copper sulfate, is a crystalline in nature. Okay, now next is your efflorescent substance and deliquescent substance. What are efflorescent substance? These are crystalline hydrated salts. Efflorescent substance are crystalline hydrated salts, means they contain what water of crystallization in their loose chemical combination. While deliquescent substances are water soluble salts, and when they are exposed to the atmosphere, they lose their moisture, means they lose their water of crystallization. But deliquescent substances, on exposure to the atmosphere, they absorb moisture. It is just learn these point wise so that you can learn it properly. First, efflorescent substance is a crystalline hydrated salt, while deliquescent substance are water soluble salts. Efflorescent substance, they lose their moisture on exposure to the atmosphere, while deliquescent substance, they absorb moisture from the atmosphere when they are exposed to the atmosphere. And efflorescent substance, on losing their moisture, what's happened? They change into amorphous state. Amorphous means powder like substance. While deliquescent substance, after absorbing moisture, they change into liquid state, means saturated solution. And what this phenomenon is called? It is called efflorescence. The substance which are water soluble salts, which absorb moisture on exposure to the atmosphere and change into liquid state, this phenomenon is called deliquescence. Right, what is called deliquescence, and what this phenomenon is called efflorescence, which what's happened, the substance or salts which on exposure to the atmosphere lose their moisture and change into amorphous state. Now next is your, just look at the examples which you have to learn. Washing soda, sodium carbonate 10 H2O, right? And copper sulfate and globose salts, these are what, examples of efflorescent crystals or efflorescent substance or efflorescent salt. And deliquescent crystals are iron 3 chloride, because question may ask, okay, name the trivalent metallic chloride which is deliquescent in nature. That is your iron 3 chloride. Calcium chloride is a divalent. Okay, it is a calcium chloride is a divalent metal chloride, and sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, and magnesium chloride. These are what learn these deliquescence crystals or substances by heart. Okay, now next is your all of you know here calcium chloride, iron three chloride, sodium hydroxide. These are what deliquescence crystals. And what's happened when they are exposed to the atmosphere, they absorb moisture and change into liquid state or saturated solution, right? But one thing which I want to actually, common salt is not a deliquescent, but when it common salt turns moist or sticky on exposure to the air. Why? Even your common salt is not a deliquescent, but why it turns moist or sticky on exposure to the air? Actually, it contains small amount of calcium and magnesium chloride. And what calcium chloride and magnesium chloride? These are two are what deliquescent substance, which when come in contact with air or moisture, they absorb this moisture and change into liquid state. That's why what's happened? It the common salt turns sticky or moist on exposure to air. Why? Because they contain small amount of calcium and magnesium chloride impurities, which are deliquescent, right? Okay, children, now rest of the part I'll explain in the next video. Thank you, children.